Hello guys, another day in this fascistic country, it's called Greece, but I have Wolf here, who makes me smile. Is that right, Wolf? How can you not smile when you have a creature like this one? Listen here, this is from pleasure. Wolf, say hello to everybody. Give me your hand. Give me your hand. Give me, give me. Look at these eyes. We just had some chicken, so as you can see, we're in the mood of playing. But now, we're not going to play, we're going to make our model. So, in the last video, I was painting, let me get this closer to me, alright. I have focus. In the last video I was painting the office's quarters, this little piece over here, also the stern, it's painted black, the other side as well, it's the same, no need to film. As you can see, everything looks beautiful, and we are here at this step. As I can see right now, we're going to place the two supports for the rear lifeboat, also the rudder, and then we're going to place the cannon port lids. After that, we have a lot of work in the bow, and then it says here that we're going to place the dies. I'm not going to place the dies when I reach this point. I'm going to skip it. The dead eyes will be placed on after the varnish of the hull, and we have a lot of way until we get there. So let's start from the first part, placing the supports for the real life boat and also making the rudder. Let's see how it goes. Let me gather my materials, place the camera on a tripod, and I'll get back to you. Now let's begin. The first thing we're going to place, it's a piece right here in the middle. Don't know what it's for, probably for the flagpole, if I'm not mistaken. We will see, don't care about that now. The piece must be 4x4 in 8mm long and in shapely wood. Let's see. As I can see here, I have to make it to have an angle. Yeah. Also on top.
All right. And in the middle of it, I have to make a hole of 2 millimeters. Let's see here. This is 2. It barely fits. Doesn't say how deep this should be, so I will leave it there, and if I need later I can do it all the way. Also here I have to place a couple of rings left and right, and I will have to place some rings over here at the bow, but everything will be done after it's varnished, not before. So I will take a rain check for that at the moment. Now let me see where the middle is. It's very hard, no need to do any measurements. I have done the measurements when I was making the deck. So the middle is where these two planks are touching. That's exactly right here. I cannot find the appropriate tool right now, but I'm not going to mess around with the cyanoacrylic. Also, I don't see it in the photos to be touching here. So I did place it a little over. You can see there's a gap, but I can see in the photos that there's a gap. So I hope I'm not doing it wrong. Now, let's move on. Let's see what the next part is. The next part is these two pieces here for the boat. They are H1. Let's see what H1 is. H1. They are pre-cut, prefixed. So I probably will be able to find them. Yeah, here they are. Let me get my ruler. I'm also going to remove the rudder because this is going up next. Now, let's clean them up. Again, I believe this type of wood is not appropriate because it's plywood. I believe that this should be African walnut or sapeli, and shape it. Don't matter that it's laser cutted, it's not the right wood. So let me clean them up and I'll get back to you. And while I was saying that this wood is wrong, when I try to open up the holes, 1 millimeter that is, here the front piece went off, so it's glued. I will have to reopen the holes after the glue is dry, because this is plywood and this is layers of wood pressed together. So when you open holes big enough in the center, you make the layers not to be able to glue together and they come apart. This is the wrong piece of wood for these pieces. You have to have solid wood like sapeli or African walnut. Anyway, let's glue what we have here. Not finished yet. We have to open up a small hole and insert a nail at the end. The hole should be 0.8 millimeters. The plans tell me to stain this up with colored varnish. I'm not going to do that. I'm going to leave it as it is, just varnish it when the time is come. So let me clean up the rudder, find the materials that I need, and I'll get back to you to place it. Also, I opened up a 5 millimeter hole here, guys, for this piece, for this to go inside. So let me take some measurements. and also round up this little edge to be able to fit in there. And I'll get back to you to make the rudder. Before continue, I'm going to make a touch on my own that I do in every rudder to make it look even better. What I have to do now is make the rudder. This is a small one, so I will draw three lines. We'll do that also on the other side, but let me show you first this side. I will use a flat nose screwdriver. If you are able to see, you will see that one side is a little bit cut off and trimmed. So I have markings without destroying the rest of the wood. Let me do that on the other side and I'll get back to you. Both sides. Hope I got some focus. Don't here. Both sides, guys. Perfect. Now, let's place one together and I'll do the rest on my own. Try to have this piece parallel to the rest of to this axle. You can see if it's parallel or not at this point here. Here is the axle, you can see that it's parallel or not. So we need to cut it. We need to cut it approximately here at the hole, and also we need to make a couple of holes, 0.8 millimeter that is. Let's cut it first. Two nails. We only need the heads. Now let's glue. have to clear the other side as well. Okay, it will work. Let me glue this and I'll get back to you. Got it, guys. Let me do the rest and I'll get back to you to mount it on the ship. Got it. Now it's time to make the preparations to place it on the ship. First of all, we need to place these hinges over here, like this, exactly like this. Don't care about how open they are, how close they are. You can adjust everything later. Just make sure that you have the right length. Let me remove a couple of tools here. Don't want to damage the paint. So this is goes over here. Here we can have a full length, also here, also here. So no worries about that, we can have a full length in every single one. First of all, we have to make them stay here. To do that, we need a piece of this wire. How long? I believe I have to make it stay there. That's good enough. So we need three pieces. Cut the first, measuring. Six millimeters. it's hard to make it stay. Okay. Have to make it stay so I can glue it. I only need the glue to last until I nail everything on the ship. That's the idea. Let me do the rest. I'll get back to you. Now, guys, let's place it together. Be careful of the height. Make sure that this is. This part is the continue of this part. When you have the height right, you can nail the first one. Always use the 0.8 millimeters drill. Here my hammer. Sorry guys, my hand is on the way, but there's no other way to do it. Got it. Now let me get this one too. With the same way, I'm going to nail each and every one of the entire part. Three nails on each side for each of these metallic parts. That's nine nails one side, nine nails the other. Let me do that and I'll get back to you to show you the finishing result. And done. It wasn't very hard, just time consuming. As you can see, everything is fit perfectly and nailed down. So this was mostly the rudder, the video for the rudder. Thank you very much guys for being with me and watching. I will see you soon to the next step, where we're going to place the lid covers for the gun ports. And also we will do some work at the bow. See you soon.